A differential equation gives you the slope of your function y of x everywhere in the xy plane. But if you know then where to start, and if you know the slope everywhere, then you can construct your solution graphically. And this is done using a so-called direction field. We will encounter such a direction field in this video, and we will learn how we can construct the solution of our initial value problem using this direction field. So, let's use the example, dividing x equals x plus y. And suppose we start somewhere with our solution. Suppose our solution goes to the point x equals 0, y equals 1. So what would be the slope then of our y of x if we start at 0, 1? Well, just plug in x equals 0, y equals 1 in the differential equation, and we would have a slope of 1 in this case. So if we are at the point 0, 1, we have a slope of 1. Now we can do that for a few more points. So if we are at the point 0, 0, our dy dx would be 0 plus 0 equals 0, so a slope of 0. So then solution would behave like that. We had the 0, 1 already with a slope of 1. If we have x equals 1 and y equals 0, our solution would go to through that point. The slope would also be 1, so we have a slope of 1 over here. And if our solution would go through the point 1, 1, then we have a slope of 1 plus 1 equals 2. So 1, 1 is the point here. So we go a bit steeper like that. And if you continue like this, you can draw all those arrows in the plane. Well, I have to do that a lot of times, so we are not going to do this by hand. And if you let the computer make such a figure, you get something like this. Whole plane full with arrows. And now this those arrows give you the slope of your solution. So if your y starts somewhere, over here for example, we see that the arrows are pointing down, so our solution would go downwards. And then starts to move horizontally, and the arrows are going up, so then we go upward again. So you start somewhere, the arrows tell you the slope, so the direction in which you have to go. That's why then we have the name direction field. And then in this way you can construct the solution of your initial value problem numerically, just by following the arrows. And of course you can do that for any differential equation. So question is, why do you need calculus? Why do you want to do something analytically? Why do you want explicit solutions? Well, several good reasons. Well, first of all, in real life problems you often have parameters. So it's much easier to study the parameter space if you have explicit solutions. You can see easily what happens in terms of your parameters. And second, if you do something numerically, you always have rounding errors. That's the nature of a computer. There's no infinite precision. And it's even worse than it seems, because those rounding errors can even cause some different physical mechanisms, like what's called numerical diffusion. So rounding errors are even worse than they seem. And third part, well, if you have some complicated differential equation and you just program it, then you don't really know whether you made bugs or not. So it's really nice to have some easy solutions to test your code. That's the third reason. You solve easy cases, you program them, you check your code to see whether it solves the easy cases correctly, and then you use your code to compute a solution of more complicated differential equations. So there are many reasons why we want to be able to find explicit analytic solutions of differential equations as well. And methods to find those explicit solutions will be discussed in some later web lectures.